We're here with Robert Garcia, one of the best trainers in the history of boxing. What a crazy day, Robert.
Yeah, it got a little crazy, especially in the weigh-ins, but it's been a good quiet week. You know, it's been really quiet. Today is the first day where you see a lot more people, you know, coming in for the weekend. There's a lot of parties going on. There's obviously the boxing, so a lot of boxing people around. It's getting a little crowded now, but earlier this week was pretty quiet.
You know Loma, you know Haney. What did you make it a push? Because no one saw it coming.
Yeah, I didn't expect it, and I didn't see it coming. And I didn't see it at all. You know, I just heard a lot of noise because we were in the back, obviously. But then when I seen the video, it was a hard fucking push. It was like really like hard work to a point where other fighters, Loma won't do that. But other fighters could fake an injury, and actually not really fake. They could actually get injured. You know, because that push was so hard that it could have hurt somebody's back. It could have hurt Loma's back, neck, or something.
Shoulder, twist an ankle. There's a lot of injury.
Hopefully, Loma doesn't wake up with a sore neck or something, because that push was fucking hard. It was like really hard. But I think Haney is a very talented kid and actually a good person too. Him, his dad, they always give me nothing but respect. We actually talked before he walked into the scale and before he left after the win. Like I told you, I didn't see the push, so I didn't know what had happened. When he left the weigh-ins, you know, obviously he had already pushed him, but I didn't know. He came up to me, we were talking about, because he was wearing a Chivas jersey, and I told him, he came up to him like, "Why you didn't like my shirt?" I'm like, what are you talking about? So I got up, I'm like, I thought he was like trying to make something out or something. I'm like, what are you talking about? And he's smiling, "You didn't like my shirt." I'm like, "What shirt? What are you talking about?" I had no idea what he was talking about. He's like, "My shirt on Twitter, you said something about my shirt." So I'm like, well, I don't do, I'm, you
it's
know,
Pita.
Pita's one doing my Twitter. So Pita showed me a picture of him wearing a Chivas jersey. So I'm like, oh, I know what the fuck you're talking about. Yeah, you were wearing the wrong shirt, bro. They just lost last night. And if you were wearing the shirt, you know, you're also, you know, you don't want to wear that. That's a looser shirt. He's like, all right, next time, give me one of the other team's shirt.
I said, you need
an America shirt. He's like, all right, next time give me one. So when he was walking out already, like after the push and everything, he came up to me and says, "So remember, you got to give me my shirt." I'm like, "I'm going to get you that shirt." And everything was cool, but I didn't know he had, you know, what had happened. If I would have known, you know, I think me as a, you know, grown man, his dad, you know, I think he's probably younger than me, but, you know, still, you know, young people, tell him, you know what? There's no need to do stuff like that, you know. He's a very likable kid. He's not one of those that's always, you know, talking shit. No, he's very likable. So keep it like that. You know, things like that start getting, you know, to where fans might start disliking him for doing things like that. You know, because he was talking about Loma being a dirty fighter, which that's totally a false. You know, he was just saying that so the ref could be aware of it, so the judges could be aware, oh, he's a dirty fighter, so we got to keep that in mind. So it's also part of a game plan, you know, to get into his head and make the judges, the, you know, whatever, you know, maybe because he's planning on punching and holding, so the ref
1-2 clinch,
you know what I mean? So the ref is aware of that, so he's gonna be okay. Loma can't punch when they're holding, because that's a dirty move. Because that, you know, that's what I think.
It's
that's
really
what,
not dirty, but yeah.
Yeah, but I think that's what Haney was trying to get out there, so the ref, the judges, everybody thinks like that. But I think now with that push, I think that kind of went against him. I think now the ref, even the judges, the fans, they're all gonna be cheering for Loma now, even though Haney's the favorite to win and Haney's the one that should win, I think now people are hoping to see the opposite hoping to see Loma at his best, which I, from what I've been hearing from people, that he's in the best shape of his life, that he trained like never before. So if he fights a smart fight and, you know, and those punches that you don't see are the ones that land and hurt. And Loma throws a lot of those motherfuckers. Loma's good at that shit.
Not only that, but there's a risk when you do like a push. Remember Thomas DeLorme was your fighter. He fought Kareem Mayfield in New Jersey. They made a record payday of like $100,000, but they lost for putting hands on each other, 20%.
Right.
What if Haney loses 20% of his purse for the push?
You think that's going to happen?
What? No, but they said they're going to fine him, so okay. I don't know. But so, even if $100,000 is still a lot of money.
Well, see, that the thing is that, yeah, it is a lot of money, but if the fight still goes on and the fight, then good. Okay, so you lost $100,000. Fuck it, it is what it is. Fighters have lost more, you know, sometimes because of weight, you know, whatever. I think the risky thing is that push was so hard that it could actually could have injured Loma. It could have injured his neck, his back, his shoulder, his ankle, you know, falling back into somebody. You know, it could have been worse. You know, it seemed like Loma's okay. You know, he did interviews after, and it looks like everything's good, but. But he could have been injured and the fight would have been canceled.
Loma
and
said
that's the part that we
you don't want.
Nobody would have won.
Loma said afterwards, he's mine now. I took his best shot. I said, and Haney says, I just wanted to send him a message that I'm the bigger man.
Yeah, well, I don't think that's the way to send him a message. I think that was a mistake. That was wrong of Haney doing that. It could be, you know, he's also a kid. He's what, 24?
Yeah.
Okay, so
no he's experience,
also,
yeah.
He's also very young, so I think he's also experienced. He did that out of, you know, out of just maybe a little nervous, you know, the event.
He saw Tank do it, so he...
You know, so you know what I mean? So things like that, maybe he felt it's something I need to do, but I think it was a mistake. But, you know, he's still going to be a great fight. I can't wait. It actually gives me a little more to see it. Both ways, not just in, oh, well, Haney's the bigger man, the younger one. Loma's 35, so, okay, we could already say he's already towards the end of his career. All that stuff. No, now I want to see it where, fuck, I want to see what Loma could do, you know, after what happened. And, you know, you kind of lean towards Loma now.
We saw Loma 10 years ago. He came to your gym. That's where he started out. Yeah. He was very impressive. Very you impressive. Had your guys spar him, and he did everything different.
Since day one.
But he's very, and
you can't find anybody to spar with if you're going against Loma, it's like going against Pacquiao. Like you can't find guys to spar that or Navarrete. How the fuck do you find somebody?
Or Maidana.
Or Maidana. You know.
Or Mayweather.
How do you prepare? How do you find guys that are gonna fight like Navarrete or you know Loma? Loma's very difficult to find guys that can fight like him. So
it's a good fight.
It's gonna be interesting. I can't wait for the fight.
Ellie Seckback, reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com.
I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.